Hello, 8th standard students. In the last session, we have already studied about a circle chart or pie chart. We have studied how to read pie chart, and also we have studied how to draw a pie chart. Now, with the help of this information, we will start to solve exercise 5.2. My first question: a survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people liked in a city. The adjoining pie chart shows the findings of this survey. This is my pie chart, and from this pie chart we can easily say that 40% people likes to hear light music, 20% people like semi-classical, 10% people like classical, and 30% people likes folk. Okay, so with the help of this chart, I can easily that there are more numbers of people are like to listen light music, and only 10%, which is less numbers, likes to listen classical music. So from this pie chart, we have to answer the some questions. So my first question is, if 20 people liked classical music, how many young people were surveyed? Okay, this is now a tricky question. They give us a number of people which liked a classical music, and 10% people likes classical music. So 10% classical people which likes the classical music, that means these are the 20 people. So with the help of this information, we have to find out the total number of people which were surveyed. Okay, so look at here, the total number, let the total number of people be x. Now we will assume that total number of people will be x, and out of the x students, the number of young people which were surveyed for the classical is 10%. So the classical music of the total people is 20 people. So 10%, that means 20 people. So 10% means what? 10 upon 100, and 10% of x people. So 10 upon 100, that means, look at my cursor, okay, 10%, that means 10 upon 100, and 10% of total number of people, that means of x, so of x is equal to 20. So this 0 and this 0 will be cancelled because both 0 at the unit place, so remain here 1 upon 10, so 1 upon 10 of x is equal to 20. Now this 10 is for the dividation. When it changes its place, so it will be form as a multiplication. So x will be 20 into 10, that is 200. So 200 people were surveyed to find out the group of young people which are liked different types of music. My next question, which type of music is liked by the maximum number of people, that we already have find out. Light music is liked by the maximum people, that is 40-100. If cassettes company were to make 1000 CDs, okay, there is a one company which it have to make 1000 CDs of these different types of music. Then how many each type of would they make? Look at here. This is my graph, which shows that 40% for light, 20% for semi-classical, 10% for classical, and 30% for folk. So total number of CD is equal to 1000 that we have given in our question. So number of viewers who like classical, okay, classical is only 10%. So we will find out 10% of 1000. 10%, that means 10 upon 100, so this 0 and this 0 will be cancelled. Okay, now what will remain here? Now look at here, we can write in another way also, 10 upon 100 into 1000. okay. Now if this is very easy process to cancel as the 0 0 0, okay, we have to cancel the 0 which are at the same place, okay, the both zeros are at the unit place, okay. Now we will place this unit place and this 10 place, so what will remain only here? 100. So 100 cassettes should be of classical music. As like this, number of viewers who like semi-classical, and semi-classical is for 20%. So 20 upon 100 into 1000. Now how will we cancel as this 0? 20 upon 100 into 1000. This zero will be cancelled. This zero and this zero will be cancelled. 2 into 100, that is 200. As like this, we can solve other also. Number of viewers who like light music. Light music is for 40%. So 40 upon 100 into 1000. By cancelizing the zero, we get here 400. So number of viewers who like the folk music, 30%. That means absolutely it will become 300. But we will check. 30 upon 100 into 1000, that is 300. So as like that, you can solve this question. So please read this, whatever is shown on the screen. I will wait for some time. Okay, I hope this is very easy for you. The next one. Question 2. A group of 360 people were asked to vote for their favorite season from the three seasons: rainy, winter and summer. Okay, this is my table. The first season is summer, and the number of votes that summer gets 90, rainy 120 and winter 150. Okay, this picture shows the denotation of this different season. Okay, now my first question: which season got the most votes? Which season? Yes, it is correct, winter. So winter season got the most votes, that is 150. Find the central angle of each sector. Already in the last session, we have studied how to find out the fraction of 360 degree. In the last session, we have studied to find out the or to doing the calculation on between three or more columns. And now in this session, we are going to see the calculation in a shortcut way also, because in one column we can do our calculation. Now look at here how we can do. Season, numbers of votes, and directly we can write central angle. Central angle, that means the angle at the center of a circle, which is 360 of circle, huh? So my first season is summer, and the number of votes is 390. Okay, now you can see this, how we can find out this denominator number. Already in the last session, we have discussed that we can find out this denominator number by taking a total of the given frequency, and the total of the number of the given frequency is 360. So 90 upon 360, this will be the my fraction. And why we I am going to multiply this 360 degree? Because I have to draw a circle chart, and we know that the measure of the circle is 360. So every time to draw the pie chart to find out the central angle of the circle, we have to multiply whatever given fraction is there, we have to multiply it by 360. So 90 upon 360 into 360. So these 360 and 360 will be directly cancelled. So my central angle is 90. For rainy season, the number of votes are 120. So 120 upon 360 into 360 degree. This 360 and 360 will be cancelled. So 120 degree. Winter, number of votes 150 upon 360 into 360. So this 360 and this 360 will be cancelled. So central angle is 150. So as like that, with the help of this given information, we have to draw a circle chart or pie chart. So we have to draw a pie chart to show this information. This is my information that we have find out with the help of given data, and this is my pie chart. Already in the last session we have studied how to draw a pie chart. First of all, we have to draw a circle and we have to point out the center of the circle, and on this point we have to place the middle part or middle point of the protractor, and with the help of this given angle we can draw angles in circles. Okay, so you can see this, the summer portion is covered by the horizontal or sleeping line. This rainy season is shown by dotted line. So it is not necessary to do this, like just you have to show the information. Winter 150%, summer 90%, rainy 120%. Okay, so as like that you can draw a pie chart. Just try to do it in your notebook. Now question number 3, draw a pie chart showing the following information. The table shows the colors preferred by the group of people. Okay, this is my table, and blue color preferred by 18 people, green color preferred by 9 people, red color preferred by 6, yellow color preferred by 3, and the total number of people is 36. Okay, in this question they give us a total number of people, but sometime some questions does not give us total, so at that time we have to find out the total number. Why? Because this total number we are using at the denominator place while finding the central angle. So the table to find the central angle of each sector is like this: colors, number of people, and central angle. Blue 18, green 9, red 6, yellow 3, and the total number of people is 36. So we have to use this number to place at the denominator. So 18 upon 36 into 360. Why into 360? Because we have to denote this information into the circle, and the angle of the center of the circle is 360. So 18 upon 36 is equal to 360. So this 36 ones are 36, and 36 tens are 360. So 18 tens are 180. Same for green, 9 upon 36 into 360. So 36 ones are 36, 36 tens are 360, and 10 nines are 90. Red, 6 upon 36 into 360. 36 ones are 36, 36 tens are 360, and 10 6 are 60. For yellow, 3 upon 36 into 360, so 36 ones are 36, 36 tens are 360, so 10 3s are 30. So as like that we have to draw these and measures of angles in a circle like this way. So dear students, please stop this video and try to draw this pie chart with the help of this information. The following pie chart gives a mass code in the examination by the student in Hindi, English, Mathematics, Social Science and Science. If the total marks obtained by the students were 540, now in this question they are gives us a total marks, that is 540. Answer the following questions. This is my chart. So I will wait for the some time. Try to read this pie chart. ओके सोशल साइंस 65 डिग्री, साइंस 80 डिग्री, हिंदी 70 डिग्री, इंग्लिश 55 डिग्री एंड मैथमेटिक्स 90 डिग्री. ओके दिस डिग्री दैट मीन्स आउट ऑफ 360 बिकॉज सर्कल हैविंग मेजर इट्स 360 डिग्री. ओके सो एज लाइक दैट द सब्जेक्ट्स एंड सेंट्रल एंगल्स. नाउ हाउ मेनी मोर मार्क्स वर ऑब्टेन In which subject did the student score 105 marks? So hint is given, for 540 marks the central angle 360 degree. So for 105 marks what is the central angle? Look at here, for 550 marks the central angle is 360. So for 155 marks the central angle will be, look at here, this we have to do here multiplication for the cross marks. Okay, so we can write here 360 into 105 upon 540. So this 0 and this 0 will be cancelled. 36 and 54 comes in a table of 9. 9 4s are 36, 9 6s are 54. Again, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. And we can divide this 105 by 3. So 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9, and 3 5s are 15. So 35 2s are 70 degree. Okay, so 70 degree. So corresponding subject is 70 degree. Okay, now how many more marks were obtained by the students in mathematics than Hindi? So marks obtained in mathematics is shows the 90 degree, that is 90 upon 360 into 540. So I will get here 135. And marks obtained in a mathematics more than Hindi. So I have to do here subtraction. 135 minus 105, that is 30. Third, examine whether the sum of the marks obtained in a social science and mathematics is more than that in science and Hindi. This is little bit complicated, but it is easy, complicated to understand, but not for solving. Look at here. Central angle of science, social science and mathematics, that is 65 degree plus 90 degree, that is 155 degree. Central angle of science and plus Hindi, that is 80 degree plus 70 degree, that is 150 degree. So marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than that of the marks obtained in the science and Hindi. So in this example, it is not necessary to find out the exact marks. With the help of the fraction of measurement of fraction of 360 degree, we can find out that marks obtained in social science and mathematics is more than that of the marks obtained in science and Hindi. The number of students in hostels speaking the different languages in given below. Display the data in the pie chart. Okay, this is my data, language and numbers of students. So 40 students can speak Hindi. 12% students speaks in English, 9 students speaking Marathi, 7 students speaking Tamil, 4 students speaking Bengali. So total students are 72. So as like this, we have to draw our table by using 3 columns: language, number of students and central angle. Okay. So Hindi 40 out of 72, and we have to find out the major in the sulcar chart, so into 360 degree. So by calculation, 36 ones are 36, 36 twos are 72, and this 0. Again 2 ones are 2, 2 5s are 10. So every time 360 upon 72 will come 5. 72 ones are 72, 72, 5s are 360. So 45s are 200, 12 5s are 60, again 9 5s are 45, 7 5s are 35, 4 5s are 20. Okay, so as like that, by using this information, I can draw a pie chart that you have to draw yourself. Okay, so while drawing the Hindi 200, you can see this, our protractor shows 180 degree. Okay, so this is 180 degree. This is a point of 180 degree. But and more, you have to find out a 20 degree more to show the Hindi. So with the help of a protractor, you have to take more another point after 20 degrees, so it will become 200 degree for the Hindi. Okay, just try to do it, and if you have any query, you can ask me. I will solve it. So as like this, you have to solve exercise 5.2. So don't waste your time. Try to solve this exercise 5.2 in your notebook. Till then, have a good day.